Well, the next phase of the rapidly expanding gathering place in Tulsa will open to all Oklahomans this coming Monday. The Discovery Lab is adjacent to the park and is expected to welcome 250,000 visitors annually, many of them young, talented STEM students. Kennedy Sepulvedo got a tour this week and she joins us now. Kennedy.
Yeah, Rich. A lucky few have already seen what the Discovery Lab new location offers. The move to the gathering place from downtown Tulsa means more space for families to have a good time while learning about science and technology when it opens to the public.
Tulsa's newest 50,000 square foot attraction is drawing plenty of attention.
When we drove by and saw the bigger location, I was really excited. I can't wait to see it.
Angela Johnson and her kids have just a few more days to wait before they can go inside the new Discovery Lab.
We went to the Discovery Lab when it was downtown, and we loved it because they have so many different activities and they change up their station every few months. So it's really neat because you can keep coming back and then they refresh it so it never gets old.
The changing exhibits are part of Discovery Lab's identity and something that will continue at the new location.
The high facilitation areas will change out every month, so that's a quick change out. Then the featured hall will change out every 15 to 18 months. And then throughout the museum, we'll have changes that'll constantly be happening. But the idea is that every time you come, there's going to be something different to participate in.
Some of the interactive science experiments are as simple as fans and fabric, where kids get to learn about wind and vortices.
Sometimes it's the most ordinary things that you look at them in a different way, in an extraordinary way, and use them. I think kids have that gift. And so we're trying to just kind of capitalize on that ability for kids to really play with anything. And at the same time, they're discovering science.
Not only are kids discovering science, some are even helping to improve the interactive experiments.
The other day we saw this student, a young guy, who said, wait, parachutes, fans and fabric. And so he took the parachutes over to fans and fabric and created a new exhibit. Had we thought of that? No.
Director of Education Chip Lindsay says the whole point of Discovery Lab is that kids get to be a part of the scientific process.
Making your own wonderings about what could happen if, you're actually doing the process of science. And for us, that's like the best part of this, is that you get a chance to really do science rather than just hear about science or learn about the history of science, or you get to experience it.
Tulsa's Discovery Lab is full of interactive science, but the best part, it's fun for all ages.
So we're going to be starting an adult night series, and it's all on the art of science. And so there'll be four different nights that we'll be putting together.
From adult nights to accessible discovery programs for underserved students and to the Little Lab for ages four and under, Discovery Lab has something for everyone to enjoy and for anyone to create.
And so each year we bring in students, high school students, who help us dream big. One of them a couple of years ago thought, wouldn't it be great if you had a roller coaster that was powered by the sun, so it'd be a solar roller coaster. Wow, how would that work?
The answer to that is shining a light at the back of the coaster, powering it up to the top, and letting gravity do the rest.
We're always looking for the right way to partner in meaningful ways with students, with teachers, with other organizations, like-minded organizations, because we know that what happens inside these walls is great, but it really gets phenomenal when we go outside of our skin and start working with the community at large.
The museum's next door neighbor, the Gathering Place, is one of those partners.
Since Discovery Lab is our neighbor and here at Gathering Place, our teams work collaboratively. Our horticulture team works very closely with them, as does our security team, and parking obviously is something that we all share.
The new addition brings excitement to the already beloved Gathering Place.
We're just really looking forward to seeing families going into their museum and then welcoming all the families who visit the museum here at the park.
The master plan for the Gathering Place, which cost close to $465 million to create and was largely paid for by the George Kaiser Family Foundation, included plans for a brand new children's science museum.
They were talking about this park that they were going to be building and that we were a great fit for the park.
The Kaiser Foundation donated the land Discovery Lab sits on, and other Tulsa community members pitched in to make the $51 million Interactive Science Museum come to life.
Oh, a lot of private foundations, corporations, and individuals. And then we also got $8 million through the City of Tulsa Vision sales tax initiative.
On Tuesday, a Google grant to support an after-school pilot program called Discovery Lab Riverwalkers was announced. It will link students with opportunities within STEM-related career paths. The program will start in Mays County and then extend to Tulsa County in the near future.
We're so fortunate to be in Tulsa, and Tulsa is so fortunate to have this institution here right now. Oh my gosh, come and see us.
If you plan to take your family to Discovery Lab, remember to mask up. All guests over 5 years old are required to wear a mask.